Hey, my name is Daniel, and today you will learn how to set up your digital mixer for multi-track recording and virtual soundcheck. Let's go! I will use a Midas M32 in this video, but the same concept applies with any kind of live mixer. The only difference would be how the routing menu looks with different brands. Type A to type B USB cable. Plug it into the back of the mixer, turn it on, and plug it into your computer. First thing we will do is go to the setup menu, all the way to card, and here we will choose the configuration of inputs and outputs. I like to keep them all active, so I will keep 32 in, 32 out. Now we will go to the routing menu, and as you can see, the channels are in blocks of 8. And there's also a record mode and a play mode. This menu might be a little bit confusing, but here's how it works. On the input page, local means the XLR inputs on the back of the console. So we're gonna tell the mixer that channels 1 to 8 get local 1 to 8, 9 to 16 get local 9 to 16. If you're not plugged into the back of the console or you're using a stage box or digital snake, it will be AES50 1 to 8. AS59 to 16, etc. Now we're done with the recording part, but before we go to the computer, we're gonna configure the playback inputs. Go to play mode, and we're gonna tell the mixer that channels 1 to 8 are getting their inputs from card 1 to 8. Channels 9 to 16 from card 9 to 16. Before we start recording, make sure that the project file and the console are running at the same sample rate. This is very important, or else the recording will be basically unusable. So you're gonna go to setup and check the sample rate. If it's 48 kHz, create your project in 48 kHz. If it's 44.1, create your project in 44.1. If you're using a Windows machine, you're most likely gonna have to install a driver called ASIO4ALL V2. Now we are in Ableton. Press Ctrl, comma to open the preferences. Go to audio, and then the driver type is ASIO, ASIO4ALL V2. Now click on hardware setup. Make sure you select the N32 USB, which is the mixer. Sample rate is 48 kHz, similar to the mixer. Now go to input configuration. By default, only channels 1 and 2 are active, so we're gonna go ahead and activate the rest of the channels. If you're using any stereo inputs, also activate those. If you want, you can name each input, channel 1 for example, and the stereo inputs the same thing. Now we're gonna click OK. Output configuration, same thing, activate the outputs, OK, close this. I haven't found any shortcuts like in Pro Tools to be able to do this automatically, so you're gonna have to do it one by one. Select external input, channel 1, and for the output, same thing, external output, not master, and go to output 1. And do this for as many tracks as you need.
Now go back to routing and put it in play mode.
Now the tracks are going back into the mixer. And now you can do your virtual sound check. If this was helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and if you have any questions, ask me in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.